Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be creating a lemur for Dalmotion's Divus collab. Why lemur? Because I love lemurs. So let's go ahead and jump right into this video. For this we're going to be using a Rochelle Goyle upper body and a Heath Burns tragic burn victim lower body. I had already removed all of her hair a while ago when I first got the doll, so all we need to do is chop her ears off. I had already previously remembered that my nail polish remover didn't work last time. It was a tragic mistake. So we're just not gonna remove her face because it's kind of pointless. And then we boil her head in some hot water to remove it safely. We won't be needing that right now because now we are going to focus on her bodies. We're going to need to cut her lower body off. And same thing with tragic Heath Burns. To do that, we are going to be using my tiny little baby Dremel. It works. And now that that is done, we are only going to be using the parts that we need. I didn't have any hot glue at the time, so I had to put her together with masking tape. And I mean, it worked, but it caused a couple of problems later on, which I'll explain later. And now we're just gonna pop her head back on. Then I cover her chest cavity with epoxy, aka my baby. Also, sorry if there's any, like, background noise. I live with my entire family, so it's pretty loud. I then decided to thicken up those hips because it still looked pretty manly, and that wasn't really what I was going for. I think it's really cool just watching this footage back and seeing all the things that I did because it's really cool. And now on for the second pass of epoxy. I just kind of thickened her tush a little bit, looking at lemur tushes. And here it is, all done. Now we just have to wait for it to cure. But while that cures, I decided to work on her little lemur ears, and they were actually extremely hard to make. They took me like an hour to sculpt, but I'm really proud of them, so yeah. Here's what the ears looked like once I was done sculpting. And now for the long and dreaded process of sanding. You may realize that I'm sitting in my bedroom because it was late and I was tired, so deal with it. Now, remember when I said that the masking tape was a bit of a problem later? This is why. It caused a big crack in the epoxy, but nothing like a little bit of super glue can fix it. And now that the head and body are cured, it's time to spray it with Mr. Surfacer. I always mess that up. It's probably going to be an ongoing thing. Here she is all gray, you know, beautiful. But can we take like a second to like re-acknowledge how amazing Rebecca's face mold is? I mean, like, look at that. I decided to paint all of her lemur markings off camera because it was just taking too long, y'all. So, yeah. Now I'm doing her face up. While looking at references of lemurs, you can see my phone in the background. So one thing that I really wanted to keep in mind with her face up is the lemur yellow eyes and weird looking pupils. I decided later on that I was going to give her green eyebrows and green hair because why not? You know? If you can't already tell, all of my videos are not scripted, so I'm technically just talking to myself a lot while watching a video that I made. So now on to those absolutely horrifying pupils. This is actually my second attempt at the eyes because the first attempt was honestly horrifying. So yeah. It was really hard to do her lips since it was just like a patch of black. So I had to figure out, like, how I was gonna make them, like, dimensional. So I ended up adding some highlights on the cupid's bow in the lower part of her lip. And it really just gave them a little pop of color, you know? And yes, I did not decide to do this at 12 p.m. So I'm a lot more energetic. So, that's good. And then gave her blush. This was a mistake. Don't do this. No. I got rid of it as soon as I could. It was not good. Not good at all. And here's her pretty much all done. Look at that face up, y'all. Look at that. It's really good. It's really cute. It's in my style and I love it. Not for the tail. I was really confused, so I just drilled a hole in her butt, and then I stole the tail from a lemur plush that I had, RIP lemur. I trimmed it and inserted a wire to it, and here is her tail. It's beautiful, and I love it. It's floofy, it's soft, and I love it. I don't know how many times I said that. We're just gonna use super glue to put it in, but it was pretty pointless because it ended up just breaking off anyways, so. For her outfit, I decided to use this Jennifer long top because it has a really cool dragon on it and it kind of fits the theme, but I did crop it so that way it looked nice. I then made her this skirt, and then time for that green hair that I was talking about, and here's just some footage of me making the skirt. I just want to say thank you to Dollmotion for hosting this doll collab because I've always wanted to make a divus doll and I've never had the perfect time to do it other than now. So, thanks a lot. And here she is all done. I really hope you love her as much as I do, and if you do, leave a like and subscribe. Goodbye.